Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back to my channel. It's Live in Color with me, Raven Danielle. And today I decided to have our chat here at the beautiful beach. Look at the water. It is just so gorgeous out here. So I wanted to just have a heart-to-heart with you about narcissist. It's pretty much a second part because there is so much involved with narcissist. And I wanted us to talk about becoming free from that, because you can be free from it. I know I got free, and I want you to get free too. So I'm just gonna have a seat and we're gonna chat about this. The word of the day is free, because I want each one of you to be free. I want you to be free from any narcissist in your life, anyone that is tearing you down, making you feel like you don't have purpose, making you feel like you don't belong here, making you feel like you're not the masterpiece that God has created you to be, because that's not so, and that's not the truth. In my first video about narcissists, I spoke about what they do and how they make us feel, how they first build you up, but it's just a ploy to tear you down and to demean you. And it's actually just to get control of you. But today, I'm going to talk about the process of getting free from a narcissist. So this person that I was freed from, I had to separate myself from them. And it was extremely hard, but I knew it was time. We had this big blowout. They actually cussed me out. And they had done stuff like that before, but this time I knew I just had to let go. So after they did this, I decided that I didn't want to contact them anymore. I didn't want to be around them anymore. And let me tell you, it was so hard, because most people don't understand that when a narcissist has a hold on you, it's a hold that is hard to let go of. So even though this person treated me wrong, even though they were the worst, even though they tore me down, they were my norm. I was used to them. And after I let them go, I really wanted to call them back. I wanted to talk to them, but I had to be strong. So in order to do that, I really had to get closer to God. And this included me reading the Bible more, because God created us. He knows our purpose. He knows why we're here. And if I wanted to know my purpose, He was gonna be the only one that could reveal it to me, the only one that could show me. So I would read scriptures. Even if it was just one scripture, I would read scriptures and then I would cry, and I still wouldn't feel good. I would feel bad, and I would have these things replaying in my mind. Why are you here? Why are you in this place? How did you let yourself get here? Why did you let this person treat you like this? You just need to go back and be friends with this person again and talk with this person again, because, you know, it's your norm. And I would just have all of these replay in my mind over and over again. I would always question myself. And then when I would be around others, you know, I didn't like me. So I would let people dictate, you know, things about me. After that person broke me down about what I should wear and how I should look, everything bothered me about what people said about me. Oh, I don't like that jacket. Oh my gosh. I didn't say anything then, but I'd go home and I'd be upset and I'd cry and I'd be like, oh my gosh, like, they don't like me. They don't care about me. Every little thing would get to me. because that narcissist had years of tearing me down. So again, I kept reading the Bible, I kept reading scriptures, I kept crying. And not only that, I would go to work, I would go to church, I would go to events, and not one person would know what I was going through because I knew how to put on a show. I knew how to look happy and act happy when on the inside, I was truly crushed to my core. But I knew how to play it off. And some of you may know how to play it off too. But I know deep down on the inside that you're hurting and you're broken. So I kept reading the word, I kept reading the Bible, I kept going to church. And even though I was hurting, I didn't realize that as I kept these actions up, as I kept hurting through it, it was lifting little by little by little. Until one day, I was just like, oh my gosh, like, I actually feel good. I started to know what my purpose was. I started to know what I was supposed to do here on this earth. And I started to like myself. I started to like me because I knew that God liked me. In fact, I know God loves me and I know He loves you too. It's just time for you to know it. But I started to know because reading God's word and going to church and surrounding myself with loving, caring people that actually built me up, it truly helped me. And it built me up over time to the point where now I know my purpose. You can't tell me that I don't have a certain purpose in this earth because God, the Creator, has told me that I have a purpose. And in His word, in John chapter 8, it says, whom the Son sets free is free indeed. God sent His Son Jesus to set us free. He's come to set everyone free from condemnation, from shame, from hurt. I know you feel hurt. I know you feel shame. I know you feel like you don't want to be here. I know you feel like you don't have purpose. But those are all lies. Those are all lies that were fed to your soul by someone who you weren't even supposed to be attached to. And guess what? That doesn't have to be like that anymore. You have to make a decision in your mind to let that person go. And when you do let them go, I can't sugarcoat it. It's gonna hurt. You're gonna have feelings that you're gonna wanna go back to that person. You're gonna want them to be in your life. You're gonna wanna keep moving on with them, but you have to hold strong. You have to know that it's time to let them go. And it's time for you to be free. It says, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. That means wherever God is, there is freedom. And I speak that there is going to be such a freedom in your life that even as you're watching this video, that you just feel the Spirit of God come in and give you such a peace on the inside of you. Even the tears flowing from your eyes are going to be tears of joy. I know they're tears of hurt right now, but they're going to be tears of joy. It says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. God is coming to you right now to give you strength, and He's doing that through joy. So remember, it's a process. It's not always going to be something that's going to be easy when you're letting this person go or these people go or this group of people go. Not something that's going to take 5 minutes and you're just going to be great again. It's going to take a little time, but I promise you, it is worth it. I have such a joy on the inside. After I let this person go, it's about, I'd say, maybe 5 or 6 years ago. Yeah, maybe about a good 6 years ago. After I let this person go out of my life, it was a process, but I have such a joy on the inside now. Oh my gosh. And it's a joy that I can't even explain. And that's how I know that it is a joy that only God can give. Only God can give this joy. And it'll give you such a peace, such a love. It's such a freeing experience. It just gives me joy to even be here out in nature with God, knowing that He loves me, knowing that He's created me for a purpose, and He's doing the same thing in you. Remember, He loves you, He cares about you, and He wants to be there for you. Thank you so much for listening in. I truly, truly hope that this has helped you today. I even plan on getting off of this video and praying for you. I am going to be praying for every single person listening to this video right now, that God comes in and frees you, and that you experience the joy that only God can give. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button below, because I want you to be tuned in for more pocket chats about different things, because we are going to be free and full of joy and full of God's purpose. I love you, beautiful people.